Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 24. We are going to solve problems in the normal shock. So, in the earlier lecture, we discussed the theory part of the normal shock and we calculated the property change across the normal shock. And in this lecture, we will be solving problem from Anayunovsky question paper in the flow with normal shock. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in flow with normal shock. And we will be referring to these gas tables. For normal shock flow, we will be referring table number 4.1, 4.2 and 4.3 for different gases, gamma equal to 1.3, gamma equal to 1.4 and gamma equal to 1.67. So, in the majority of the problem, the working fluid will be air where gamma equal to 1.4. So, rarely they will be giving some other gases with the gamma equal to 1.3. Example number 1 from November 2008 and November 2009 question paper. If a normal shock occurs in a flow of nitrogen at a velocity of 700 meters per second, find the Mach number and the properties at the downstream of the shock. The temperature and pressure before the shock is 30 degree Celsius and 2 bar respectively. And we are given nitrogen. For nitrogen, gamma equal to 1.4. We are given velocity Cx before the shock, Cx equal to 700 meters per second, pressure Px equal to 2 bar and Tx equal to 30 degree Celsius, which is 303 Kelvin. So, the Mach number on the upstream side of the shock, that is before the shock, Mx equal to Cx divided by square root of gamma r Px. So, substituting 700 divided by square root of 1.4 into 287 into 303 equal to 2. Now, from the normal shock table, page number 53, at Mx equal to 2 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the properties My equal to 0.577, Ty by Tx equal to 1.687, Py by Px equal to 4.5. Now, the properties on the downstream of the shock, Py, pressure Py equal to 4.5 into Px, which is 4.5 into 2 equal to 9 bar. Ty equal to 1.687 into Tx, which is 1.687 into 303 equal to 511.2 Kelvin. And the answer to the problem, the Mach number on the downstream of the shock is 0.577, pressure on the downstream side of the shock is 9 bar and temperature on the downstream side of the shock is 511.2 Kelvin. Example number 2, a converging diverging nozzle has an exit area to throat area ratio 2. Air enters this nozzle with a stagnation pressure of 1000 kilopascal and stagnation temperature of 360 Kelvin. The throat area is 500 millimeter square. The divergent section of the nozzle acts as a supersonic nozzle. Assume a normal shock stands at a point M equal to 1.5. Determine at the exit plane of the nozzle the static pressure, static temperature and the Mach number. So, this is from May 2009 question paper. And these are all the data given. It is a supersonic nozzle. So, it is a converging diverging nozzle. So, we are given A2 by AT. Out exit area to the throat area ratio is 2. Stagnation pressure at the entry, PO1 equal to 1000 kilopascal. Stagnation temperature is TO1 equal to 360 Kelvin. Throat area is 500 centimeter square. And Mx. So, Mx is the Mach number in the before the shock wave, which is 1.5. So, we designate the converging diverging nozzle. 1 is the inlet, 2 is the outlet, T stands for the throat section and here we have the shock wave. So, before the shock wave, we measure the properties as X and after the shock wave, we measure the properties as Y. Now, for the flow, so in the nozzle from 1 to X, it is isentropic flow and Y to 2, it is again isentropic flow. So, the property change across the normal shock. So, here between X and Y, we have to refer to the normal shock table. So, for the property calculation 1 to X, we have to refer to the isentropic table. From X to Y, we have to refer to the normal shock table. From Y to 2, again, it is the flow is isentropic, we have to refer to the isentropic table. So, we have to refer isentropic table as well as the normal shock table for solving problem in the normal shock flow. And here we have PO1 equal to POX equal to 1000 kilopascal. So 1 to X is isentropic flow, the stagnant pressure is constant, and after the shock POY equal to PO2. And for stagnation temperature from exit to inlet, the stagnation temperature is constant. So TO1 equal to TOX equal to TOY equal to TO2 equal to 360 Kelvin. Stagnation temperature throughout, it is constant. And A1 star equal to AX star equal to AT star equal to AT. So here the star stands for Mach number, area corresponding to Mach number equal to 1. So normally at the throat section, the Mach number equal to 1. So the A1 star, so the value equal to AT. And similarly on the other side, AY star equal to A2 star. So these two are equal. Now from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 32, at MX equal to 1.5 and gamma equal to 1.4. So here MX equal to 1.5. So before the shock, we take AX by AX star equal to 1.176. So AX by AX star. AX star, you refer to the table here, AX star equal to AT. So AX equal to 1.176 into AX star, which is 1.176 into 500, because AX star equal to AT, which is 588 centimeter square. AX area here, it is 588 centimeter square. Area at the throat equal to 500 centimeter square. Now from the normal shock table, at MX equal to 1.5 and gamma equal to 1.4, MY equal to 0.701 and POY by POX equal to 0.93. Now the stagnation pressure after the shock, PO2 equal to POY equal to 0.93 into POX, which is 0.93 into 1000 equal to 930 kilopascal. Now again from the isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 30, at MY equal to 0.701 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take AY by A star equal to 1.0933. Now the area ratio at the exit, A2 by A star equal to A2 by AY, I divide by AY, multiply by AY by A2 star. Again, A2 by AT, so we further expand. So further expand, A2 by AT into AT by AY into AY by A star. A2 by AT is given in the problem 2. A2 by AT is the ratio of exit area to the throat area, it is given as 2. AT equal to throat area 500 centimeter square. AY is the area at where this shock is standing, AX equal to AY. So, AY equal to 588 into AY by A2 star, AY by A2, AY star equal to A2 star, so AY by A2 star equal to 1.093, so calculating it is 1.86. So, A2 by A2 star equal to 1.86. Now, referring again isentropic table, table number 3.2, at this area ratio and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 0.3323, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.9261, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.977. Now we calculate the properties at the exit, P2 equal to 0.9261 into PO2, which is 0.9261 into 930 equal to 861.27 kilopascal. T2 equal to 0.9777 into TO2, which is 0.9777 into 360 equal to 351.97 Kelvin. The answer to the problem, properties at the exit, M2 equal to, Mach number equal to 0.3323, pressure equal to 861.27 kilopascal, and temperature equal to 351.97 Kelvin. So I recall the problem solving technique for the normal shock table, referring to the diagram once again. So you have to, depending on the given data, so remember 1 to X, we have to refer the isentropic table, and Y to 2, we have to refer to the isentropic table again. X to Y, so across the normal shock, we have to refer to the normal shock table. We will take another problem so that we will understand the concept. Example number 3. A converging diverging nozzle operates at off design condition while conducting air from high pressure tank to a large container. A normal shock occurs in the divergent part of the nozzle where the cross section area is 18.75 centimeter square. The stagnation pressure and the stagnation temperature at the inlet to the nozzle are 0.1 megapascal and 36 degrees Celsius respectively. The throat area is 12.5 centimeter square and the exit area is 25 centimeter square. Estimate the exit Mach number, exit pressure, loss in stagnation pressure, entropy increase in the during the flow between the tanks. This is from May 2009 question paper. And this is the diagram once again. So here what is given? AX equal to AY. So the area where the shock occurs, AX equal to AY equal to 18.75 centimeter square. Stagnation pressure at the inlet, PO1 equal to 0.21 megapascal. Stagnation temperature is TO1 equal to 36 degrees Celsius, which is 309 Kelvin. AT, area of the throat section, 12.5 centimeter square. A2, exit area is 25 centimeter square. And as in the previous problem, PO1 equal to POX equal to 0.21 megapascal, which is 210 kilopascal. POY equal to PO2, and here the temperature, stagnation temperature is constant, which is 309 Kelvin. And A1 star equal to AX star equal to AT star equal to AT, and AY star equal to A2 star. So these are all the conditions for the nozzle, convergent divergent nozzle with a shock in the divergent portion. And remember, normally the shock will occur in a convergent diverging nozzle, shock will occur only at the in the diverging portion. And the area ratio of the at the normal shock, area ratio at the normal shock, AX by AX star equal to AX by AT, which is 18.75 divided by 12.5 equal to 1.5. Now for this area ratio, from Mach number, from isentropic table 3.2, page number 34, AX by AX star equal to 1.5 and gamma equal to 1.4, MX equal to 1.885. Mach number before the shock equal to 1.855. Now refer to the normal shock table, table number 4.2, page number 53, MX equal to 1.855 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the properties. MY equal to 0.605, POY by POX equal to 0.788. Now the stagnation pressure after the shock, PO2 equal to POY equal to 0.788 POX, which is 0.788 and 210 equal to 165.48 kilopascal. Again from the isentropic table, for the MY equal to 0.605, page number 30, MY equal to 0.605 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the property AY by AY star equal to 1.1825. Now exit area ratio, for the exit section, A2 by A2 star equal to A2 by AY into AY by A2 star. So A2 by AY, which is 25, A2 equal to 25 centimeter square, AY equal to 18.75 centimeter square. And we have taken AY by A2 star. AY star equal to A2 star, which is 1.1825 equal to 1.577. So the area ratio at the exit equal to 1.577. Now refer to the isentropic table again. So refer to the isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 29, where A2 by A2 star equal to 1.577 and gamma equal to 1.4, M2 equal to 0.404 and P2 by POT equal to 0.8934. Now the pressure at the exit, P2 equal to 0.8934 into PO2, which is 0.8934 into 165.48 equal to 147.84 kilopascal. And the stagnation pressure loss, PO1 minus PO2 equal to POX minus POY. So the stagnation pressure loss across the normal shock wave are between inlet and the outlet of the nozzle. So 210 minus 165.48 equal to 44.52 kilopascal. The change in entropy, delta S equal to R into logarithmic of POX by POY, which is equal to 287 into logarithmic of 210 divided by 165.48 equal to 68.38 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, the exit Mach number is 0.404, exit pressure is 147.84 kilopascal, loss in stagnation pressure is 44.52 kilopascal, and the increase in entropy increase during the process is 68.38 kilojoules per kilogram. Next problem, example number 4. A supersonic nozzle provided with a constant diameter circular duct at its exit. The diameter of the duct is same as the nozzle exit diameter. The nozzle exit cross section 3 times of its throat. The entry conditions of the gas, PO equal to 10 bar, TO equal to 600 Kelvin. Calculate the static pressure, Mach number and velocity of the gas in the duct. When the nozzle, condition 1, when the nozzle operates at its design condition. Condition number 2, when the normal shock occurs at the exit. Condition number 3, when a normal shock occurs at a section in the divergent part where the area ratio A by A star equal to 2. Assume gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and this is from November 2010 question paper. So we are given PO1 equal to 10 bar, TO1 equal to 600 Kelvin, area ratio A2 by AT equal to A2 by A2 star equal to 3. So here it is given, the diameter, the nozzle exit cross section is 3 times its throat. So A2 by AT equal to A2 by A2 star equal to 3. When the nozzle operates at the design condition, so completely isentropic flow. When it is operating at the design condition, it is completely isentropic flow from inlet to the outlet. So when the nozzle operates design condition, we take PO1 equal to PO2 equal to 10 bar. From isentropic table 3.2, page number 36, A2 by A2 star equal to 3 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take M2 equal to 2.64, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.04715, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.417. Now the properties at the exit of the nozzle are at the in the duct. So P2 equal to 0.0471 into PO2 equal to 0.0471 into 10 equal to 0.471 bar. T2 equal to 0.417 into TO2 equal to 0.417 into 600 equal to 250.2 Kelvin. And the C2 velocity equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 2.64 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 250.2 equal to 837.05 meters per second. So this is the first part. Second part, when a normal shock occurs at the exit, so when the on the exit side, when the pressure occurs. Now from the normal shock table, table number 4.2, page number 54, at the MX equal to 2.64. So outlet Mach number is 2.64. So the shock wave occurs on the outlet, so MX equal to 2.64 and gamma equal to 1.4. Now MY equal to 0.5, TY by TX equal to 2.279, PY by PX equal to 7.965. Now the properties at the exit, that is properties at the duct after the shock, PY equal to 7.965 into PX equal to 7.965 into 0.471 equal to 3.75 bar. And the TY equal to 2.279 into TX equal to 2.279 into 250.2 equal to 570.2 Kelvin. And the velocity is CY equal to MY into square root of gamma RTY, which is 0.5 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 570.2 equal to 239.33 meters per second. So this is the second part of the problem. When a normal shock occurs at the section, third part, when a normal shock occurs at a section in a divergent part where the area ratio A by A star equal to 2. So here it is occurring. So this is the duct. The cross, the area properties at the outlet of the nozzle is equal to the property at the duct. Now from isentropic table 3.2, page number 35, at A2 by A star equal to 2 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take MX equal to 2.2. So here the Mach number equal to 2.2. Now from the normal shock table 4.2, page number 53, MX equal to 2.2 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take MY equal to 0.547 and the POI by POX equal to 0.628. Now the stagnation pressure after the shock, PO2 equal to POY equal to 0.628 into POX, which is 0.628 into 10 equal to 6.28 kilopascal. And from isentropic table again, page number 30, MY equal to 0.547, gamma equal to 1.4. Now we take the property AY by AY star equal to 1.2595. Now the area ratio at the exit, A2 by A2 star equal to A2 by AT into AT by AY plus AY by A2 star equal to 3 into 1 by 2. A2 by AT equal to 3 and AY by AT equal to 1 by 2. So because the area where the shock occurs divided by throat area equal to 2. So into 1.2595 equal to 1.889. Now again from isentropic table 3.2, page number 29, A2 by A2 star equal to 1.889, gamma equal to 1.4. We take the properties M2 equal to 0.3265, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.9288, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.9783. And the properties at the exit, P2 equal to 0.9288 into PO2, which is 0.9288 into 6.28 equal to 5.833 bar, T2 equal to 0.9783 into TO2, which is 0.9783 into 600 equal to 586.98 Kelvin, and the C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.3265 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 586.98 equal to 158.6 meters per second. So the answer to the problem, so we have to calculate Mach number, pressure in bar, velocity in meters per second for different three different conditions. So when the isentropic condition, the Mach number is 2.64. When a normal shock occurs at the exit, Mach number is 0.5. When the normal shock occurs at the divergent portion, this 0.3265, and the pressure is, look at the pressure, 0.935, it is perfectly acting as a converging diverging nozzle. So the second and third, the shock occurs because it is act, then the diverging portion is acting as a diffuser. So this is these are all the answers to the problem. Example number 5, a normal shock occurs in the divergent section of a convergent divergent nozzle. Throat area is 1 by 3 times the exit area and the static pressure is 0.4 times the stagnation pressure at the entry. Mass, the flow rate through the throat is throughout isentropic except the shock wave. Determine Mach number Mx and My, static pressure and area of cross section of the nozzle where the normal shock occurs. This is from May 2014 question paper. And this is the nozzle, converging diverging nozzle with a shock at the diverging part. We are given A2 by A2 equal to 3 and P2 equal to 0.4 times of PO1. So look at the definition, the static pressure at the exit, P2 equal to 0.4 times stagnation pressure at the entry, PO1. Now, as we said earlier, PO1 equal to POX, POY equal to PO2, TOY equal to TOX equal to TOY equal to TO2, and throat area A1 star equal to AX star equal to AT star equal to AT, and AY star equal to A2 star. Now, for the flow through nozzle, we have A star PO1 equal to A1 star PO1 equal to A2 star PO2. So, A1 star by A2 star equal to PO2 by PO1. So, the PO2 by PO1 is the stagnation pressure ratio. A1 star divided by A2 star is the ratio, area ratio. Now, we have A2 by AT equal to 3. It is given in the problem. Area at the exit divided by area at the throat section equal to 3. Now, we modify A2 by A2 star equal to A2 star by AT. So, multiplying and dividing by A2 star, it is equal to 3. We take this as equation number 1. Now, we have A2 star by AT. A2 star by AT equal to A2 star by A1 star. So, because AT equal to A1 star. Now, this equal to, from the definition, so PO1 by PO2. So, already we have derived here, A1 star by A2 star equal to PO2 by PO1. Now, we are using A2 star by A1 star equal to PO1 by PO2. Now, in this equation, you substitute A2 star by AT as PO1 by PO2. So, here, substituting here, A2 by A2 star, and A2 star by AT equal to PO1 by PO2 equal to 3. Now, we are given in the problem, P2 equal to 0.4 times of PO1. So, A2 by A2 star as it is, P2, so PO1 equal to P2 by 0.4 into 1 by PO2 equal to 3. So, simplifying, A2 P2 divided by A2 star PO2 equal to 1.4. Now, we take this value, A by A star, P by PO equal to 1.2. Now, we refer to the isentropic table, 3.2, page number 29, at gamma equal to 1.4, and A by A star into P by PO equal to 1.2. Now, we take M2 equal to 0.472, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.859. Now, P2 equal to 0.859 into PO2, which is 0.4 into PO1. So, because P2 is also given, already it is given as 0.4 into PO1. Now, we calculate the pressure ratio. PO2 by PO1 equal to POY by POX equal to 0.4 divided by 0.859, which is 0.466. Now, refer to the normal shock table for the stagnation pressure ratio. POY by POX equal to 0.466, table number 4.2, page number 54, and gamma equal to 1.4. We take MX equal to 2.58, MY equal to 0.50X, and POY by PX equal to 9.145. Now, the static pressure before the shock PX equal to POY by 9.145. So, POY equal to 0.466 PO1 divided by 9.145 equal to 0.051 into PO1. Again, from isentropic table 3.2, page number 36, MX equal to 2.58 and gamma equal to 1.4, AX by AX star equal to 2.842, which is AX by AT. So, these are all the answers to the problem. Mach number before the shock, MX equal to 2.58, MY equal to 0.50X, static pressure PX equal to 0.051 PO1, and area of the cross section of the nozzle where the normal shock occurs, AX equal to 2.842 of AT. AT is the throat area. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. So here you find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. You refer to the book for additional problems in the flow with the normal shock. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You refer to the subscribe the YouTube channel. Use the videos for a better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another set of problems in the normal shock flow. Until then, bye bye.